Let's meet the Ramirez family. Terry, Donette, Chris, Danny, and Marion, ready for action. Playing against the Squillace family. Ralph, Bob, Lily, Cindy, and David, on your marks. Let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Ray Cohn.
Thank you. Hello, Squillace. Hello, Ramirez. Thank you. Thank you. Holy. Thank you so very much. Thank you for joining us at home. Thank you for that ovation. It's an exciting day for me because this is our special Valentine show. And we're going to do something very special today. You know, on the show, we used to kiss all the time. And because this is a very romantic show, I'm going to give kisses to everybody on the show today. How about that, huh? Including the men. So I think it should be outstanding. We're looking for a new champion. Let's say hello to the Ramirez family.
Hi, Danny.
Hello, how are you doing? Fine?
I'm doing very fine. It's a pleasure to have you on the show. Who did you bring with you to help you become the champion?
Well, I'd like to introduce you to my wife, Christine.
Here. Hi, Chris.
I have my sister-in-law, Donette.
Hi, Donette.
My brother-in-law, Terry.
Hello, Terry.
And my mother-in-law, Marion.
Hi,
how
Ray.
You doing? You might be the champion.
That's right. That's right.
But to do that, you have to beat this family. I think it's Italian. Squillace. Yes. Will you say hello to the Squillace family?
Hi, Bob. How are you?
I'm fine. It's a pleasure to have you on the show.
Thank you.
Who did you bring to help your family become champions?
I brought my lovely wife, Cindy.
Hi, Cindy.
My father, Ralph.
Hi, Ralph.
My sister-in-law, Lillian.
Hi, Lillian.
And my brother-in-law, David.
How are you doing? Two great families. I hope they're romantic families.
Oh, yeah.
I wish you both a lot of luck. I think right now we should play the feud, Danny.
All right, here we go.
Before I explain the rules, it's time to give you boys your kisses. Now, look, I've got a cold. You might notice from my voice that it's pretty bad. So I don't want to be kissing you guys. It could make you sick. So instead, I'm going to make good on my promise. There's your kiss right there.
Thank you.
How about
thank
that?
You.
There's
thank
your kiss,
you so
Bob.
Much.
Thank you. That's right. Now, you can put those down. Get ready for business. The first family, the $300, will win the game, get a chance to play Fast Money for the $5,000. Good luck. We asked 100 people this question, and the top five answers are on the board. Try to find the most popular answer. Name something that a lot of young husbands promise to someday get for their wives.
A house.
He says a house. It is number one. Back with the family, Bob. Think of a school.
Yeah.
Hey, Danny. When I give you a kiss, I want you to take it with appreciation.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
That's for you. Hi, Chris.
Hi.
Happy Valentine's Day.
Hello. Oh, thank you.
I can't
you.
Ask you to be my Valentine because Danny might get mad.
Oh, yeah, he might.
There's a kiss for you.
Thank you.
Now, can you give me number two to get your family rolling?
A car.
You say a car.
Yes.
Something a lot of young husbands promise to someday
good
buy
answer,
for their wives.
Good answer, yeah.
Let me see an automobile. There it is, number four. Hi, Donette.
Hi, Ray.
How you doing?
Fine.
Name something that a lot of young husbands promise to someday get for their wives.
I'm going to say a diamond ring.
Good answer.
Yeah. Yes.
Show me a diamond ring. Terry.
Yes. All right.
We got number two sitting right there.
Boy.
A little kiss for you, Terry.
Thank you.
Ooh, it's hard to do. Okay. Something that a lot of young husbands promise to someday get for their wives.
I don't know about this, but I would say a decent vacation.
Right. Terry says a decent vacation.
Yes, that's a good answer.
Well, it made sense, but it didn't make our survey. Hi.
Hi. How are you, Ray?
I'm very fine, and I'm better because you're on the show.
Well, thank you.
Can you name something that a lot of young husbands promise to someday get for their wives? You're making me better, you know. I feel a lot better when I touch you.
Oh, I'm glad.
When you touch me, I feel even better. Oh, no,
okay,
back to
you. Well, I would imagine that when they first marry, they don't have their beautiful bedroom suite. So I would imagine a beautiful bedroom suite.
Marion says a sexy bedroom suite. There it is. Danny, one answer, and your family has the bank with a clean sweep. What's number two?
Can I say a child, maybe?
Great! Yes!
Pretty amazing. Something a lot of young husbands promise someday to get their wives. Honey, someday I'm going to get you a kid. For the bank, show me a kid.
Oh. Come on, Chris.
All right. Either that or a bedroom suite. What do you want? Chris?
I would say a kitchen utility, like the stove. I mean, like a...
Okay,
a
you decent, say...
a new stove.
You say a new
Good
stove.
Answer.
New
Good
stove.
If stove is there, you've got the bank and a clean sweep. If not, we're going to go over here. How do you say that name?
Squillace.
Squillace. I'm sorry. I'm sick today. They're going to try to steal. Show me a stove. Not there. All right. Dave Squillace, how you doing?
Fine.
Can you name something that a young husband promises to someday give their husband, their wives?
I'll say a fur coat.
A fur coat? All right. What do you say, Lily?
Fur coat.
Happy Valentine's Day, Ralph.
A second home.
A second home.
Or a vacation home.
Come on, Ralph, lighten up, man. All right, Cindy.
A larger salary.
All right, Bob. It's up to you.
We're going with the fur coat, Ray.
Going with fur coat?
Fur coat.
Yes.
If fur coat is there, you steal the bank from the Ramirez family with one answer. Show us a fur coat. Yeah! There it is. The Squillace family. We're coming right back. You have to go all the way to $300 to play for $5,000. Come on. We are feuding right now. The Squillace family has $64. The Ramirez have zero. Let's go. It's time for another face-off. Chris. Cindy. Good luck. We've got the top seven answers on the board. We asked 100 men, if you can remember the first time you wore a necktie, what was the occasion? Cindy.
A wedding.
Let me see, a wedding. It's there, but what answer did you control, Chris?
Graduating from junior high.
To graduate from junior high. Ooh, graduation. It's there, but didn't take control. Think of a steal. I guess that does make sense. Junior high would be about the right time. Ralph, how you doing, my friend?
Fantastic.
Officially welcome to the show.
Thank you, sir.
Now, we've got the most popular answer in the survey sitting right there for you.
The prom.
The prom. Good Is that answer. The first prom? Yeah. Maybe the prom. Woo! Hey. Five people said it. It's number seven on our survey. Hi, lovely Lily.
Hello.
How you doing?
Just fine,
you
thank
seem
you.
So sweet and bubbly.
Oh, thanks.
Do you have a Valentine?
Yes, I do.
And where is he?
He's in the audience.
And how long has he been your Valentine?
For 11 years.
You don't look that old. I mean you've been married for 11 years?
I've been married for 6 years.
And you dated him for 5?
Yes.
And he was your Valentine for 5?
Yes.
Okay, Lily, it's pretty sweet. Can you remember the first time you wore a necktie? What was the occasion? If you can remember the first time, what was the occasion? We asked 100 men, what's on that board? What's number one?
First date.
The Good first answer. Date. Yeah. How appropriate yeah. for Valentine's Day. Let me see a first date. Mm. Oh. It's only the first strike. Howdy, David.
Hello.
Why don't you give me number one?
I'm going to say first communion.
All right. I don't know. Is it first communion? Yeah. Church service. 42 people said it. Very good, David. Bob.
Yes.
Three answers left on the board.
How about a job interview?
Yeah. A job interview.
It could be
Makes
that.
Sense. The crowd is behind you.
Right.
Show me a job interview. Not there. They're going to go for the steal to return the favor that you did for them, Cindy. You had no pity on them. If you can remember the first time you wore a necktie, what was the occasion?
Two answers.
Just give one, because we're all getting in trouble.
I'll say a funeral.
A funeral.
That's a good answer.
That's yeah. Very good answer.
Mm. If it's there, you're still alive. If not, get ready to steal. Show me funeral.
All right!
9 people said it. Ralph puts a little pressure on you.
An anniversary.
And an anniversary.
Parents' anniversary.
To stay alive, show me anniversary. Ramirez, excellent opportunity for you to return the favor and steal $78.
Are you back?
I am back, baby. If you can remember the first time you wore a necktie, what was the occasion? We ask 100 men.
I would probably say,
quickly.
At a very early age, probably a baptism.
Baptism, Terry?
No, he
doesn't know.
Ring bearer.
Donette, ring bearer, Chris.
Out to dinner with parents for the first
Out
time.
Out to dinner with parents for the first time. Danny, I don't know if they've been a lot of help, but there are two answers to steal from. What is one of those two?
I'll go with the baptismal.
Go with the baptism.
With
Quickly.
Early baptism.
Yes.
If baptism is there, Danny, you got the bank. If not, it goes to the Squillace family. Show me baptism. Not there. The Squillace family takes the bank. Well, it's a tough one. Now, there are two answers. I don't think that anybody in the family really hit them. I don't know. Does anybody in the crowd know number four? I heard. We will see. Number four. Photo session. I heard no one say that. Number six. School. The feud's begun. We're going all the way to $300, so come on back. The Squillace family has $142. Ramirez, zero. Let's go. It's time. We're at number three. Go on in. And round.
Come on, Donna.
The dollar value is doubled. We've got the top six answers on the board. Name a way people pass the time when they're stuck indoors during a snowstorm.
Ralph.
Watch TV.
Maybe they watch TV. Yeah. It's number one, Donna. Think of a steal your family doesn't want to miss if you get the chance. This family has come from the West. They've taken complete control of the game. Ralph, where are you from?
Los Angeles.
You guys hail from right here on the West Coast. Lily.
Yes.
Lovely Lily, as we call you on the show.
Yes, Ray.
We've got number two sitting right there for you.
All right. I'm going to say read a book.
Yes.
You read a book.
Yes.
Is number two read a book? Number three is read a book. Said by 19 people. David, now, do you have a Valentine?
Yes.
Is she in the crowd?
Yes, she is.
How long has she been your little Valentine?
11 years.
11 seems to be the key word here. Now, how long have you been married?
Six. 6.5 years.
Did you guys date for the same?
No. You were married a month before us.
They were?
Yes.
Great to see you. You seem very excited about it, too. I want you to name a way people pass the time when they're stuck indoors during a snowstorm.
I'm going to say play a game.
Yes.
Yeah. Is that good enough, Judge? The judge doesn't say anything, so I guess it is. Let me see, play a game. Yeah. All right. Now that we've established playing a game and you can't give away another answer, if you were in a snowstorm with your Valentine, what game would you be playing?
No comment.
No comment. Must be a legal game. I never heard of that. Okay. Bob.
Yes.
What is number four?
Listen to music.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. All right.
Okay.
What's your favorite music? Stumped you. You don't know.
Yeah. Pop rock.
Bob says he would listen to music. No. That's only one strike. Cindy.
I'm going to say bake.
You would bake?
Yeah, she does.
If your family continues to take this question, you're going to win the game and play fast money. Cindy says she would bake. Right. There it is. Three people said it. Big Ralph. We got three answers on there.
Look at videos.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Watch a video, maybe. People do it all the time. Watch videos. Now they have a chance to steal Lily. You're going to keep the family alive?
I'm going to try.
Okay, give me an answer.
Sit and watch the snowfall.
Ooh.
Oh, very good.
That's
good.
Very romantic. Good. Very good. Very romantic, but didn't make our survey. Sure. Show me, sit and watch the snowfall. Oh, did not. Third strike. Ramirez family, this is your chance to steal the bank. Name a way people pass the time when they're stuck indoors during a snowstorm, Marion.
Well, how about pay all their bills?
Pay all their bills? Yeah. I'd rather go out in the snowstorm, Marion, than do that.
Terry? Build a fire.
Build a fire. Donette.
Make love.
Why do you keep looking at me like that? Lucky for you, I'm sick, Donette. It's awfully lucky for you, I'm sick. Chris?
Play crossword puzzle.
Play crossword puzzles. Danny. There's a lot of different answers there. I'm still shook up by the make love, particularly the way she inflicted it upon me.
Well, I'm going to choose that. Make love.
Make love?
Make love.
No answer!
Well, if it's there, I just want to say, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Show me make love.
Yeah!
You got the bank. $156. Show me number four. Playing cards. $156 for the Ramirez family. The Squillaces, $142. Let's go. It's time for another face.
Gary. And Lily. The dollar value is now tripled. Top four answers are on the board. We asked 100 people. Name something specific you would find in a doctor's bag. Lily.
Stethoscope.
Let me see a stethoscope. It's number one. The Ramirez family. Dave Ode. Something specific you would find in a doctor's bag.
A thermometer.
Yes!
Show me a thermometer. There it is.
Yes.
People said it.
A syringe, a hypodermic.
Okay. Give it a shot. Show me a syringe. It's not there, only the first strike. Cindy, if your family takes this question, you're going to win the game.
A blood pressure.
Yes.
She says a blood pressure checker. Not there. Ralph, if they steal the bank, they're going to win the game. There are two strikes. Give me one of those answers.
The inevitable tongue depressor.
Right.
Yeah. It's got to be there.
To stay alive, let me see the tongue depressor. There it is. Five people said it. Really. One answer. You've got it?
I've got it.
What is it?
Medicine.
If number three is medicine, you are the champions. You're going to play for $5,000. If not, Ramirez, get ready to steal. Is number three for the game medicine? Yes! Are the new champions. Ramirez family's been great. That's a nice business.
Happy Valentine's Day. Thank you.
Nice party gift.
Thank you, Ramirez.
Great.
You guys are special. Thanks a lot. I need two players for $5,000. Let's go. Off, who's playing first? The Squillace family playing Fast Money right after these very important messages. The Squillace family going for $5,000. David up at bat. 15 seconds on the clock, please. Good luck, David. Name a food you like so much that you eat it even when you're not hungry.
Spaghetti.
Something you see in a park.
Trees.
How many times a week you vacuum?
Twice.
A compartment in the refrigerator.
Eggs.
A spice.
Cinnamon.
Turn around. Let's see how you did, pal. I asked you to name a food that you like so much you eat it even when you're not hungry. You said? Spaghetti. Our survey said? Zero. Something you see in a park, you said? Trees. Survey said? 23. How many times a week do you vacuum? You said you vacuum twice a week. Our survey said 37. A compartment in the refrigerator. You said the very popular egg compartment. Our survey said 19. Name a spice. You said cinnamon. Survey said 26 over 100. There you go, pal. Here comes your sister-in-law, Lily. Come on, Lily. Take a look. Take a look. You need 95 points. Look straight ahead. It's a little more difficult, so 20 seconds on the clock, please. Good luck. We're revealing your partner's answers. You can do this. Name a food you like so much that you eat it even when you're not hungry.
Candy.
Something you see in a park.
A tree.
Try again.
Grass.
How many times a week you vacuum?
Three.
A compartment in the refrigerator.
Egg compartment.
Try again.
Butter.
A spice.
Cinnamon.
Try again.
Sugar.
All right, Lily, turn around here. You. The name of food that you like so much you eat it even when you're not hungry. You said? Candy. Our survey said 18. Ice cream was the number one answer. Something you see in a park. You said? Grass. Survey said 8. You're inching up there. Very clean. Number one answer was benches. I asked you how many times a week you vacuum. You said? 3 times a week. Our survey said 15. The number one answer was 1 time a week. A compartment in the refrigerator. You said? The butter. Our survey said 47. Butter was the number one answer. One question and 7 points needed. I asked you to name a spice. You said? Sugar. I hope to God 7 people thought sugar was a spice.
Me too.
If they did, you got $5,000. Our survey said, sugar and spice and everything nice. Cinnamon, the number one answer. 193 points at $5 a point. 965. Come out here and hug this Valentine. We're coming right back. Don't go away. They almost made it.
Some of our departing families will receive From Ostrotex, a luxurious imported tablecloth. Woven of multicolor cotton and linen, it features lace trim and matching napkins from Ostrotex. Catalina's active and daytime sportswear, combining fresh good looks in richly textured easy care fabrics, perfect for any sport or leisure activity from Catalina. Ricci's Art Deco collection, silver plated picture frame, meticulous hand craftsmanship by Italy's master silversmiths. Frame your memories with beauty and luster from Ricci. Advanced formula Centrum with more vitamins and minerals, including beta carotene. Centrum, more complete from A to Zinc. Q-tips, there's no softer, safer swab, because a swab by any other name just isn't the same. Hoover's cordless double duty wet and dry hand vac picks up both wet and dry spills. Hoover keeps making it better. Television City in Hollywood, this is Gene Wood speaking for Family Feud, a Mark Goodson television production. This program has been edited for broadcast.